Juanito Gomez, also known as El Abuelo. He is the director of the founder circle of Casino and Rueda. And he is here to tell us his story and to answer your questions.
Bueno, primero que todo, darle la bienvenida.
First of all, I'd like to thank you all and give you a warm welcome.
Ustedes siempre personas lindas, porque Anara nada más que anda con personas lindas.
I know you guys are beautiful people because Anara only wanders around with beautiful people.
También por el interés a partir del baile que se ha ido produciendo en la historia del casino, en la historia de la rueda.
And I'm thankful for the interest that has been building now through these groups, not only in the dance but in the history behind the dance of Casino and Rueda.
Pido disculpas por el resto de la gente de la rueda que se irá incorporando, pero es que todavía hasta ahora la gente tiene dificultades porque salen de los trabajos.
So I want to ask for forgiveness that we don't have our whole group here, but this is what usually happens because people are still working and to get transportation over here. Usually Juanito starts and then other people come joining us as we go.
Por lo menos un grupo estará con nosotros en la misma medida que estemos hablando, se irán incorporando, si no se los presento después.
And people will come in, and then of course I will present each of them to you afterwards, so that you can know them when we go inside to the activity, to the party.
Bueno, esto del baile casino y la rueda, pudiéramos decir que es una historia apasionante.
So let's just say that this history of Casino and Rueda is a fascinating story.
Porque es una cosa que surge sin ninguna intención de crear nada o sin ninguna intención de hacer nada relevante, por lo menos.
Because it came to pass without any plan, without any specific direction to create a new style of dance.
Aquí simplemente un grupo de jóvenes, incluso muy jóvenes, lo estoy bailando desde los 11 años, 12.
It's just basically a story of a group of young people, very young. I started dancing, for example, when I was 11, 12 years old.
Just tengo 70 ya.
And now I'm 70.
No lo digan por ahí porque yo todavía me siento joven.
Don't tell anybody around here because I still feel young, but...
Nah, es un juego. Finalmente la edad es lo que uno tenga en el corazón. Yo creo que vale más que los años físicos que uno ha vivido, ¿no?
No, I'm just kidding because I know the way you have in your heart is more important than the number of years you've been living. So, it's all good.
Decía de historias apasionantes porque eran tiempos un poco extraños en Cuba antes de la revolución.
These were some strange times in a lot of ways in Cuba before the revolution.
Digo extraño porque ya para nosotros se convierte en un hecho de extrañamiento.
So I say strange because now, so many years later, the things that were happening appear strange.
Una sociedad dividida en razas, una sociedad dividida entre el hombre y la mujer, con valores diferentes.
A society that was very divided, a society that the races were separated, a society that men and women had very different roles and places they could be in society.
Por suerte, por eso digo de extrañamiento, porque ya no nos acordamos de eso, es muy difícil recordar.
And I say it's strange because it's almost hard for us to still remember this because it's not our life anymore. We have to remember, but it's like not right at our fingertips.
Para mí decir cubano significa todo aquel nacido en Cuba y no me importa si es mujer, si es negro, si es blanco, si es amarillo porque tiene descendencia china, no me importa nada de eso. Me importa los cubanos nacidos en Cuba y que hemos crecido y hemos desarrollado la vida en conjunto.
So, not for me and others like me, we just say Cuban. And it doesn't matter if you're black, white, man, woman, it's just all of us who were born here, all of us who developed here. That's what we mean when we say Cuban.
Comienzo así porque el Casino Deportivo de La Habana era un club privado de gente medianamente con cierto poder universitario, gente con dinero, clase media, pero clase media alta, el Casino Deportivo de La Habana.
So I needed to start with this explanation because the time when this dance began in the Casino Deportivo, we have to remember what this place was. It was a private club. It was a club that only white people could enter. It was a club that only people with at least upper middle class university education could enter, professionals.
Y es bien raro en un país como Cuba que haya surgido un baile con esta integración, porque normalmente lo mismo la rumba que el son, que todo lo demás, pues nos viene de una mezcla de raza normalmente, o muchas veces de la raza negra, como pasa con los orichas y con las influencias afrocubanas.
And it's strange in a country like Cuba because really most of our music and dance either came from our African ancestry or through at least a mix. So all of the music and dance that came before, you can pinpoint one of these backgrounds. Except for this one, that's why I say it has a strange beginning.
Eso sí, les puedo asegurar que el Casino Deportivo de La Habana, este lugar que está aquí mismo frente, mirando un poco para allá, está frente ahí después de cruzar el río.
And this building, the Casino Deportivo from Havana, is just across the river, across the edge of the bay, right over there.
Era de los más populares, dentro de aquellos que eran selectos y que había que pagar, eran los más populares, o sea, no era de la clase rica realmente, sino clase media, profesionales.
So it was really probably one of the most popular clubs for that segment of society. It wasn't of the very high society, it wasn't for rich people, but that kind of middle, upper middle class professionals, it was one of the clubs of choice.
Por tanto, la formación de esta manera de bailar, de esta manera de hacer, data de los años 50.
So now this way of dancing, this way of moving, pay attention that we're talking about the 1950s.
Increíble que después de tantos años siga siendo un hecho de actualidad, siga siendo un hecho que está en el mundo hoy, esta manera que creamos de bailar, que fue simplemente entre amigos, entre muchachos jóvenes.
It still seems so wild to us that this little thing we did amongst a few friends, like a little dance we made up just as a way to have fun, is now something that's known and popular around the world.
Esta condición en el Casino Deportivo de La Habana, esta condición de ser un grupo de jóvenes, incluso de jóvenes muy jóvenes a veces, siempre teenagers, algún que otro más de 20, pero siempre 20 muy pegadito a 23, 22, 21, que nos empezamos a interesar sin darnos cuenta, divirtiéndonos de hacer algo diferente.
So is this group of young people, mostly teenagers, a few younger, like him, he said he was 11 or 12, a few older, maybe 21 or 22, that without even realizing what we were doing, that through our playing around, we started to get interested in creating a new dance style.
Son los años 50, el rock and roll anda en el mundo.
So it was the 1950s, and rock and roll, or we say swing sometimes, have become popular around the world.
Esto es un elemento importante porque si ustedes son agudos se darán cuenta que el movimiento de péndulo del rock and roll, las aperturas y los cierres, las evoluciones no tanto, pero hay toda una intención de esto, de que viene la mujer, va el hombre, viene la mujer, va el hombre, no en el tiempo del vals, pero sí en el tiempo del rock and roll o en el tiempo del son cubano, para el caso del casino.
So if you start to look at it, this rock and roll was very important because on top of the Cuban dances, this influence is something that you can really see when you look at Casino. You notice the feeling of a pendulum, as he calls it, where it's like the woman comes and the man goes, the woman comes and the man goes. And that feeling that was in Casino, believe it or not, comes directly from rock and roll.
Las aperturas siempre nosotros, con el brazo izquierdo del hombre, el derecho de la mujer, se abre y se cierra. Pero simplemente el casinero no se suelta, sino más bien siempre baila en el botinón.
So at that time, what you will notice is it was a first also for us, that it was the man holding with his left hand, the woman's right hand, and rather an open position, but we also didn't fully let each other go. If you think about dances before that, they were either open or closed. They weren't in this halfway middle position.
No hay los movimientos que tenía el rock and roll, que eran un poco más acrobáticos. Todo en aquel tiempo no existía, ahora estamos viendo mucha acrobacia, pero eso es otra historia con el casino contemporáneo.
Back
en aquellos tiempos para nada se hacían acrobacia, no tenía nada que ver.
Back in those days we didn't take any of the acrobatic tricks that they had started to do in rock and roll, but we did take that feeling of the pendulum. Now, well, that's another story. You do see people putting acrobatics into casino and salsa. But back then, it was just the dance and just that feeling of the pendulum that we took from rock and roll and started to make our move.
Soporte musical es el son, lo que nosotros llamamos son sin la G final de ustedes. O sea, el son, que es por supuesto un ritmo, una manera de hacer música que nos viene desde Oriente, prácticamente invadiendo la isla hasta llegar a La Habana, con instrumentos muy rudimentarios, instrumentos como una botija o una marímbula haciendo debajo.
So let's say the backbone of the music for us would start with the Cuban song. This form of music that basically invaded across our island, starting on the eastern side and making its way all the way to Havana, starting with rustic instruments, like, for example, a comb or a water jug, maybe a thumb piano, like the box that they had brought with them from Africa.
En este momento también hay una coyuntura favorable que es que comienzan a trabajar grupos más pequeños, no las grandes orquestas o los grandes jazz band, que los teníamos también, como el propio Benny Moreno, que tenía un jazz band. No era para nada la música tradicional que venía con un simple tres, con un simple bongo, o con una trompetica, o incluso antes con un peine, con un papel, que así se hacía la cosa, digamos. Los vientos eran un papel con un peine, estoy hablando ya más tradicional. Luisa Paulaza, otro de los fundadores.
So one of the things that was favorable for the development of what would happen next is that it had been the time of the huge orchestras or jazz bands in Havana, and the music song was coming with very rudimentary instruments, very small groups with, you know, maracas, a comb, a water jug, a three-string guitar, very small groups and very big groups. And so then what started to happen in Havana was the formation of the format that would become what basically turned into salsa, or the conjunto format.
El conjunto era una formación que estaba entre el jazz band y, digamos, los conjuntos tradicionales de son, o los grupos tradicionales de son. Era un poco el intermedio de una y otra.
So we'll say it was right in the middle between the large jazz band and the small son groups.
Porque tenía seguramente el sonido del son, sobre todo lo que después se llamó son montuno, pero al mismo tiempo tenía trompetas, ya una cuerda de trompetas, ya se empezó a tocar con el bajo, nada de marímbulas, nada de botijas, y siempre un cantante, una voz líder, un par de gente que hacían los coros, como la manera que se hace ahora igual. Lo que pasa es que el conjunto lo que hacía era son y solamente son, no tenía ninguna influencia, como pasa ahora con los grupos que tienen una influencia mucho mayor de cosas.
So let's say that the conjunto that was built between the jazz band and the traditional son format would have the son instruments. They would get rid of the rustic ones and put in things like a metal section with horns. Instead of just having one singer, they'd have a couple singers to do chorus. They started to use the stand-up bass instead of the thumb piano. And they started to take the most essential instruments from the jazz band and add it to the son format, creating what would be the conjunto, looking a lot like our salsa bands today, but of course just focusing on playing son at that time.
Por alguna razón, cuando esa música de Oriente, de estas provincias, mucho más allá, bastante lejana a La Habana, por lo menos la isla es pequeña, pero lo más lejano de La Habana, llegó a La Habana, en realidad hay una metamorfosis extraña, no sé ni por qué, para los bailadores, que siempre bailaron en contratiempo o con el bajo. Y ya en La Habana, el casino se baila a tiempo, tiempo uno. Por tanto, hay una metamorfosis extraña, no me pregunten por qué, en realidad ni yo mismo sé explicarle por qué, pero simplemente sucedió.
Another thing that happened was a shift in the dancing, that the dance that had been done to son music was danced at contratiempo with a strong count on the 4 and the 8. And then when it arrived to Havana and we started dancing casino, we were using the melody for the 1 and the 5. And I'm not really sure how that happened. Don't ask me how it happened because I can't remember, but that is one other change that took place.
Quizás hasta la mezcla entre el son y el rock and roll hizo que el tiempo este del son se cambiara a tiempo uno. Puede ser una posibilidad, digo, no es que estoy seguro ni tengo la convicción de que así sea.
I do think there's a possibility that it was the mix that we put in with rock and roll, the song with the rock and roll that had us start dancing on the first count of the music or with the melody, but I cannot say for sure.
Pero lo que sí, un pequeño grupo de gente que empezamos a dar estos primeros pasos, y cuando digo un pequeño grupo de gente no pasamos nunca de 20 en el casino deportivo, eran más o menos 20, 20 y algo, pero nunca llegamos a 30 personas, ni mucho menos. Nos inventamos una historia a partir de divertirnos, a partir de prácticamente como se hace para bailar, divertirse, jugar, hasta enamorar a una muchacha o la muchacha enamorar a un hombre, que también se vale. En ese intercambio surge un estilo, el estilo casino, que no fue una cosa pensada, ni ningún coreógrafo se sentó a decir, déjame hacer un trabajo de mesa, cómo vamos a hacer, cuál es el primer paso, por dónde andamos, dónde están los pasos, digamos, lo que nosotros llamamos pasillos o movimientos diferentes. Eso nunca existió. Fue en la práctica, divirtiéndonos, compartiendo, y así surge este estilo de baile.
So basically what happened is a small group of people, and we're talking about maybe 20 people, maximum maybe 25, not even hitting 30, just started dancing as a way to have fun, as a way to make friends, as a way to fall in love, as a way to entertain ourselves. And this little group of people didn't sit down and plan out how to create this dance. We didn't have any choreographers. We didn't have anything written down. It was just as we were playing and having fun, this thing started to happen. This fusion started to happen right there in the Casino Deportivo.
En esta nueva manera de bailar que comenzamos en el Casino Deportivo, también hay otra introducción muy importante, y lo que ha definido una de las diferencias más grandes entre la llamada salsa y el casino, que es la rueda de casino.
And even in those early moments, something happened that is something that we've always said distinguishes what would become salsa in the United States and what really is casino here in Cuba. And that is what you guys have probably heard of, which is the wheel of casino, or the rueda de casino.
Simplemente también surgió de la misma manera, también como divertimento, sobre todo que siempre los cubanos hemos sido muy enamorados. Y entonces a lo mejor él estaba bailando con una muchacha que a mí me gustaba y decía, pasa, dame aquella. Y entonces en ese intercambio de dame aquella, yo te doy esta, pues surge así los primeros movimientos que se hicieron sobre la rueda. Pero les repito otra vez, nada estudiado, nada planificado. Todo por el simple hecho, bueno, buenos bailadores éramos, pero sobre todo por este intercambio jovial, tranquilo, dame la tuya. Y entonces ahí empezó ya, dámela. Empezaba a bailar en el mismo tiempo, dame la tuya. Y así empezó todo.
So just like the casino I told you started just as a way to have fun, the rueda was the same thing. We're very passionate people as Cubans, and so maybe this guy over here was dancing with a girl that I liked. And so I would be like, hey, pass me your partner. And they'd be like, okay, no, you give me mine. And we would dance next to each other and trade partners. And so very naturally, the rueda de casino started. Again, without anyone writing things down or planning any moves or anything of that sort. It was just figuring out ways to exchange partners as we were dancing and having fun.
Después, por supuesto, esto es dicho de esta manera que la digo yo, como seguramente Luis o cualquiera de los otros amigos fundadores podrían decir. Ya después, como entran los musicólogos y cuando entran esta gente que son científicos, siempre ya las palabras son otras. Y al final usted a lo mejor no se lleva la esencia de lo que realmente fue. Pero bueno, ellos siempre demuestran que saben un poco más que uno, ¿no? Eso sucede.
Una pregunta. Cuando ya fue formado así socialmente por diversión.
Sí.
Pero en un punto llegaron donde ya tuvieron que decir, no, tenemos que ponerle nombre a las cosas para poder enseñárselo a las nuevas personas.
No por el tema de enseñar, sino por un problema de disfrute otra vez.
Exacto.
O sea, empieza la rueda de esta manera que yo digo, un intercambio ahí, tranquilo, porque me gustaba más aquella muchacha y empezamos a intercambiar. A partir de eso, ya la gente empezó a preocuparse un poquitico de que qué lindo hacer una cosa como esta. Y empezaron a aparecer los distintos movimientos, los distintos pasillos, como decimos nosotros. Y ya se empezó a organizar un poco, pero organizado entre nosotros mismos. Ningún coreógrafo, el que diga que el casino tuvo que ver con algún coreógrafo que lo pensó, está diciendo absolutamente una mentira. Porque esto fue entre los propios bailadores. Sí, perdón.
Primeramente fue él, después él empezó a hablar sin que yo tradujera él. Ok, so he his first part, then we'll try to do Franklin's question, and then we'll try to do his second part. So he said that he's trying to give you the story of how it felt to them as it was happening, and that later musicologists have come back and looked at patterns and been like, well, this really evolved from this, and you know, you might hear things like that, like maybe this evolved from contradanza, or whatever it is that you might hear from musicologists. And so they could probably look from the outside and see certain patterns, but they're trying to tell you kind of the way it felt to them as it happened as kids. And so they're hoping that you enjoy that version of the story, because you can see what they were feeling as they went along. He and Luis and the other people will be joining us. So that was part one. Any Spanish speakers who think I missed something?
No, you're good.
Call it out. Okay. So part two.
My question was that, yes, it all started out of fun, but I'm assuming that at some point they had to sort of formalize, make it formal, the training, so they can teach to some other people. Then he says that no, it still became a social thing, and that over time people were interested in it, and then they started gathering so that they can name things properly and they can pass it on.
And he said that one of his focuses was not necessarily teaching others, but they like to be in the limelight. So when they noticed that people liked when they passed partners, they kind of wanted to do it in a more fancy way. And they were like, oh, this one looks cool. Let's do this one. Let's try to remember it. So it was almost like developing an easier way to show off, let's say, as they went dancing.
Por tanto, estoy hablando de un proceso. Cuando hablamos de la rueda de los fundadores, estamos hablando de un grupo de personas, la mayoría, porque ya hemos tenido que sustituir a alguna gente más nueva, producto también de que hemos tenido ya algunas personas muertas, que ya no están con nosotros, y por supuesto hemos tenido que ir sustituyendo. Pero esta rueda de los fundadores es la primera rueda del mundo. O sea, usted no tenga duda que después cuando bailemos los fundadores por la noche, yo no voy a poder bailar, yo sigo con un problema ahí que me tengo que operar. Pero cuando bailemos por la noche van a ver la primera rueda del mundo. Por algunos de los protagonistas que bailaron desde ese tiempo.
So, when we talk about the founders group, and it's the group that you're going to see dancing out here later tonight, rest assured that even though we have some different people, because of course we've had people pass away in our group, we've had to go substituting, you're seeing the moves that made up the first rueda in the world. We're keeping those moves alive. The moves that we started to establish in the process that Franklin was talking about into a rueda, those are the moves you're going to see tonight. He said that he's not going to be dancing because he still has a problem in his abdomen that's making him need to have surgery, but that the rest of the group will be dancing, and you'll be able to see some people who are from the very, very earliest days at the Casino Deportivo, then some people from the next generation that he'll talk about in a moment, and even some younger people that they've had to kind of substitute in to make sure that their circle stays alive as the years keep going, but they will be doing the moves of the very first rueda.
A mí a veces me da un poco de temor cuando yo digo la primera rueda del mundo, porque yo mismo me quedo así un poco impresionado. Digo, Dios, carajo, porque es fuerte eso, ¿no?
So sometimes,
pero en realidad no se puede decir de otra manera. Es así, es la primera rueda del mundo.
So sometimes I get like a little scared when I say something like the first rueda in the world, because that feels like a big deal. Because, you know, we see so many ruedas that I'm like, wait a second, am I saying something? That's good, like the first rueda in the world, but really that's what it is. Because that's what we were doing. We were making the first rueda in the world. Although, of course, they didn't know it at the time. That it would be something we'd be talking about right now.
Sobre todo porque hoy todo el mundo quiere ser el mejor, el que más sabe, el más completo, el más popular, hasta más lindo puede ser también. O sea, todo el mundo aspira al que más o el primero. Entonces, por eso me da un poco de miedo cuando digo la primera rueda del mundo, porque es así.
So now it seems like everyone's trying to be the most popular or the most complex or the most advanced or the most attractive rueda. And so that's why he sometimes still feels like, oh, it feels a little funny to be like, yeah, we're the first. But really, that's what we were the first rueda.
De todas maneras, cuando vean bailar la rueda nuestra, la rueda de los fundadores, verán que ya no se baila así. Las voces de mando son absolutamente otras. Eso no existe en ninguna otra parte del mundo que no sea en la rueda de los fundadores.
And you'll notice when you see our rueda and you're listening carefully to our calls, that actually there's probably nowhere in the world that they still use these calls. Like, we have a lot of calls that are now outdated. There are certain moves that we have that people don't use anymore, but we are keeping them alive so you'll be able to see them tonight.
De ahí únicamente los seguidores nuestros, los seguidores míos, de alguna forma, este proyecto Rueda de Casino que ustedes ven ensayando ahí, que son dos brigadas diferentes, que es el grupo que creamos. Algunos de los coreógrafos, alguna de la gente que más tiempo lleva conmigo, ya no bailarines porque ya tienen otra edad, pero el coreógrafo principal, por ejemplo, fue de mis primeros alumnos. Y sí hacíamos la rueda, esta que yo llamo rueda clásica o rueda tradicional, que es, por supuesto, de la manera en que la hacíamos en aquel tiempo. Hemos tratado y hemos logrado de que no se incluya ahí nada nuevo en lo que nosotros hacemos, sino simplemente el respeto a la historia, el respeto a los primeros movimientos que hacíamos, que ya los muchachos se encargan de cambiar todo. Algunos de la gente mía, de los coreógrafos míos, sí hacen la rueda tradicional, pero es bien difícil un joven haciendo rueda.
So they make sure that their rueda stays being the traditional rueda, so that it kind of can be preserved in time, and you guys are able to see what happened way back when. And they have taught he has taught his generations of students here. Like, he has a project for young people to make sure that Rueda Casino stay alive. There are the kids you see practicing over there. And the choreographers are from his, like, first generation of kids that he worked with. So he makes sure that they know the classic moves. And he said, but it's very hard to keep the young people doing the classic moves because they always want to create something new. So they're trying to maintain it, and he's hoping that the young people will remember as well to be able to maintain it too.
Se tiene una pregunta, Luis, ¿no?
Hubo
un momento donde se peleaban, donde no llegaban de acuerdo a cómo nombrar ciertos pasos y cómo los resolvían. The question is, was there ever a time where they argue about how to name the steps and how did they resolve such a dilemma?
O sea, el nombramiento de la figura, ¿no?
Sí.
No, en eso no había mucha discusión, eso nos ponía muy de acuerdo porque nosotros nos reuníamos, analizábamos los pasillos, y en base a lo más práctico, pues eso es lo que hacíamos. Por ejemplo, si nosotros querían decir la bota, le poníamos un nombre de suelta, nosotros decíamos, no, vamos a decir bota porque tú la estás botando. Si vas a poner una figura clásica, que nosotros llamamos el paseala, había diferentes ideas. Entonces este grupo sacaba la mitad, y si es paseala, vamos a ponerle paseala. ¿Por qué? Porque la estamos sacando, ¿verdad? El paseo y paseala. Y era como la sacamos a pasear, caminamos, sí,
por abajo,
paseamos, pasea por abajo, pasea por arriba, pasea por atrás. Y decíamos, vamos al medio. En la rueda, por ejemplo, nosotros vamos al medio, ustedes vamos al medio, hombre al medio, hombre al medio, y hombre de derecha, mujer izquierda, lo hacíamos en base a la acción que se ejecutaba. Lo más parecido, de forma tal de asociar. ¿Por qué? Porque cuando usted cantaba la rueda, el líder que siempre ha sido el profesor Juanito, él canta en milésima de segundo, bótala, bótala bikini. Entonces canta, los nombramientos ayer asociados al oído, bótala, ya la boté, al medio, derecha, izquierda, para la derecha y para la izquierda. O sea, buscamos la figura más práctica de acuerdo a cómo se ejecutaba la acción.
Déjame traducir. Okay, so.
Muy descriptivo, o sea, eran siempre nombres muy descriptivos, porque la gente no sabía qué iba a hacer. Estamos hablando de la primera rueda.
¿Y por qué eso en ese momento no fueron como nombres como tal? Ustedes estaban cantando.
Sí, cantando la
fue
rueda.
Fue una cosa diferente.
Claro.
So, okay, so the first thing that Luis was saying is that it wasn't hard to come to agreement on the names because they were always using the most practical way to describe what they were doing. So let's say that they started talking and someone said, okay, well, this move is botala because we are doing that action, which is like throwing her away to the next partner. And someone would say, well, maybe you're just letting her go. And then they would talk and they'd be like, no, we're really throwing her away. So, okay, so then that's going to be the name of the move. And then he said, okay, paseala. Like, said someone will say, well, or maybe we're just walking her. No, we're really paseing her around our body. And so that's what we're going to call it. And then Juanito said, sometimes we would say, pass her higher, pass her lower. And then that would depend on where their hand was. So they were using actual descriptive words to say what they were doing. If they said left and right, it's because it was a series of turns to the left and a series of turns to the right. And then what the three of us were talking about is, I think the most important thing to note is that they weren't names of moves. It was someone having a conversation with the dancers. So none of the moves had names or like signals the way we do now. It was just someone talking. So he would say, okay, like throw away the next girl, now pass her under the arm, now go behind her back, duck your head. And so they'd be talking. And so that talking was actually what was happening, and that's why they didn't have an argument, because it was like the most descriptive way to say what they were doing was gonna be the easiest to do the rueda. And they wanted it to be easy because they wanted to be able to go out and have, like you said, Juanito, who did a lot of the calling, in a millisecond be able to tell the whole group what to do. And if they had to remember complex names, it wouldn't have worked as well. So that's the reason why they didn't have arguments about putting names, because they weren't really names. They were more like conversation, let's remember how we're going to describe this when we're on the dance floor so that everyone can see what we're doing, right?
Interesante,
you
hablar de eso mismo.
I was asking, this had to be strange when it first came out.
I can't hear you. Speak up.
I said, this had to be strange when it first came out for a woman to see, like, why does he keep on passing me and passing me and passing me? Because I wondered, like, what's going on? Why is that? What did they say? What did the women think?
Problema, y le estoy contestando a ella, pero era precisamente lo que yo quería decir, me leíste el pensamiento.
It's like, so you're reading my mind, so that was exactly what I was talking about that.
El problema es que el machismo ha existido.
So the problem is that at that time there was a lot of machismo.
Y tú tienes dos opciones, o haces una cosa a partir de lo que pensamos en siempre el hombre en el que cantaba.
So we were doing is making something that was, while we were doing well, the man was always the one in charge. He was the one saying what to do.
La primera mujer que cantó una rueda fue muchos años después de la creación.
The first woman who ever sang in a rueda was many, many, many years after it's created.
Entonces todas las voces de mando pues partían del hombre.
Every calling voice was the voice of a man.
Por tanto, toda la que era feminista pues seguramente no entraba.
So I think that at that time, well, I'm kind of kidding, but whoever was a feminist wasn't going to enter because they knew that the game was like that.
Miren, esto que yo decía de la revolución tiene que ver con un hecho que no es solamente decir, es la realidad pura. Los bailes se dieron de esta manera, pero de ninguna forma nosotros pensábamos en aquel tiempo que estábamos haciendo un hecho machista. Porque ya estaba la revolución, para mí las mujeres eran, bueno, el sexo opuesto a uno, pero con todos los derechos, con todas las posibilidades de hacer lo mismo que yo, pero era machista de dos maneras.
So now, like, when we look back, like, we realize that this was machista, like, it was only men who were calling, but that's just how we saw it at the time. Like, the man's gonna say what to do, and the woman's gonna follow, and the man has his role, and the woman has her role. So that's just what we were, doing at the time. And he said, and then the revolution came so soon after, and at the time when the dance was dispersed, which he'll talk about in a moment, the revolution, and there was the bringing of the equal rights of the man and the woman at that time, that we started to treat each other as equals and we didn't even realize our dance was kind of sexist. We just kept dancing and it worked and that was it.
Quiero decir, sí, ahora vamos para eso. Por ejemplo, nosotros siempre para empezar la pareja y siempre decíamos arriba o abajo.
So for example, we always started with our partner and we would always say go up or down.
Arriba del hombre o abajo del hombre. Cuando es
man,
al revés, cuando yo voy abajo del hombre, la mujer viene arriba.
But remember, if I say go down and the men are going down, the woman's going up.
Cuando decíamos por abajo del brazo, ¿de qué brazo hablábamos? ¿El brazo del hombre?
If I said go underneath the arm, whose arm are we talking about? The man's arm.
Bailando, perfecto. Por abajo del brazo. Por abajo del brazo del hombre, no de la mujer.
Siempre machismo.
Siempre machismo. Todavía nos queda un poquito.
¿Por qué dice que no?
Mira, es que en realidad ahí hay varias excepciones para eso.
So in reality, there's many different stories about that.
Oh, I asked why dile que no.
Dile que no, ¿por qué? Porque está el bótala o el dile que no. Cuando tú la botas, la sueltas. Cuando le dices que no, te quedas haciendo el movimiento, pero sin soltarla.
So you remember that there's basically the bótala, which we say dame now, which is like getting rid of the girl. And then there's the same movement, but you stay with her. And that's the dile que no. So we're like, no, don't go away. I'm not throwing you out.
O sea, estamos haciendo X evoluciones, X movimientos.
So we're doing whatever movement there is.
Dile que no. El hombre entraba, ran, movimiento, pran, pran, ran, pero te quedabas con ella.
So
dile
man,
que no, o sea, no la botes.
He accepts the woman and he takes her and he puts her to the other side, but no, he doesn't throw her away.
Todo era muy descriptivo, o sea.
Everything was so descriptive.
Ya después la gente inventa nombres y hasta nombres propios. Algunos de los muchachos bailan ahora y dicen un nombre propio y es un tipo de pasillo que lo inventó alguien.
And so now people actually use names, like people create names for what they're doing, and maybe people even name it after themselves, or like someone names a move after someone or after a place. That's what's happening now.
Déjame terminar ese pedacito nada más.
But let me finish this thing that I'm trying to explain.
Porque recuerden ustedes que estamos hablando de aproximadamente 20 personas que por primera vez bailaban. Digo 20 por decir un número.
So remember, I'm saying 20 to say a number. It could have been 25, but remember, we're talking about a very small group of just 20 people that knew each other as we were getting started.
Pero hay un proceso de incorporación posterior. Que era gente que bailaba por primera vez otra vez. Cada vez que se incorporaba uno, para él estaba descubriendo una cosa nueva que no existía. Por tanto, fue durante mucho tiempo, esos pasos fueron descriptivos. Porque siempre había uno nuevo que si tú más o menos le decías de qué se trataba, más o menos entendían. Si tú ponías un nombre que no tuviera que ver exactamente con el movimiento, era mucho más difícil aprendérselo.
And so then remember, we have these 20 people, but then when after the revolution they started to include more people, now you have new people coming in, and if it's not descriptive, they're going to mess up the dance. So you have to be describing it as you go. If you have a name that people are supposed to know what it is, you're not going to be able to include new people. So the dance isn't going to be able to spread. So you have to keep going back to the root and seeing how can you make everything you're doing descriptive so each round of new people is able to follow along with what you're doing. At least that's how it was in the beginning. Not now, but in the beginning.
De todas maneras, quería preguntar, y él también,
piensa tú que él habló ya y tú todavía no se ha escuchado la voz.
¿Quién era Evelina y Echeverría?
Echeverría es un movimiento de ahora. Es uno de los movimientos de ahora que inventó alguien, yo ni siquiera yo lo conozco, no sé quién es.
Yo escucho historias de Echeverría, pero sí de los años 80, 90.
Pero eso sí, es mucho más para acá.
So he says Echeverría is something that's like from way later. And I said, I hear stories about the invention of Echeverría, but from the 80s, 90s, not from the 50s, like he's talking about.
Suena como si un poquito joven.
Anything that has a name, that's really a name, you can be sure was invented later. Anything that's descriptive, like camínala, para arriba, cambia, derecha, izquierda, anything that has like a description in it is probably from earlier. Does that make sense?
Es como cuando ellos ya eran 20 y se estaban integrando más, decidieron dar un mandato, un nombre a algunas figuras nuevas ya para que la gente...
Sí, pero no en esa época.
Not at that time. We weren't adding names at that time. Everything was descriptive when we were 20 people. Everything was descriptive.
Mira, para mí los cambios empiezan en la rueda, sobre todo en las voces de mando. Estamos hablando ya de los años 70.
70,
y estamos hablando del 50 y tanto que fuimos nosotros los fundadores.
So we were like from the 1950s, años después. And I would say that we didn't start having names or changing the way of calling until maybe the 70s.
De ahí se ha hecho de todo. Nosotros hemos tratado de mantener la historia como va. O sea, los fundadores bailamos la rueda, esa clásica que yo estoy diciendo.
So we're trying
y no incorporo nada que no sea eso.
So what we're trying to do as the founder circle is make sure we keep that early rueda alive and we don't incorporate any new moves. We don't make any changes. We just keep showing those steps so that you can still see it. But we can tell you when we remember the changes to start.
Bueno, yo pienso que para mí, ¿no? Y pienso que para todos es un honor y es muy especial conocer dos de las personas que inventaron un género nuevo en el baile y que ha sido un éxito mundial, porque yo he estado en muchas partes del mundo y lo he visto en todas partes. La pregunta es, ¿cómo se sienten ustedes al ser las personas que aportaron un nuevo género de música? Bueno, música y de baile a la vez, podría decir, en todo el mundo. The question is, well, I told them that first of all, I was speaking for myself, but I think we all agree that it's both an honor and special for us to meet two of the people who created a new genre of dance that is a worldwide phenomenon, and that I've traveled all over the world and I see rueda everywhere. So how do they feel having been the ones who started this new phenomenon?
Mira, nosotros en realidad nos sentimos muy contentos con esto. ¿Por qué? Porque nosotros éramos un grupo de jóvenes. Desde muy pequeño estábamos bailando casino. O sea, nosotros el único interés nuestro era bailar, bailar y bailar. Si no bailábamos, era como nos faltaba el oxígeno para respirar.
So for us, we are just so happy with this because remember who we were. We were just young people who loved to dance. All we wanted to do was dance all the time. It was like if we didn't have dancing, we couldn't breathe.
En la historia de cualquier evento, en este caso del estilo del baile casino, siempre ha habido mucha diferencia entre nosotros mismos. En la historia, al principio, siempre hay diferentes criterios. Sin embargo, hoy día, es lo único que todos nosotros, los fundadores, coincidimos, es que ninguno de nosotros iba a imaginarse ni pasarnos por la mente que ese baile que nosotros ayudamos al fortalecimiento, al crecimiento y a la consolidación, iba a llegar hoy día a ser el baile más popular que hay en Cuba.
So there is a lot of discrepancies when we all start talking about the history, about little bits of stories that some people remember and that other people remember. He said, but the one thing that everyone always agrees on 100% is that nobody had any idea that we were creating something, doing something, or consolidating something that would one day be thought of as the most popular dance in Cuba.
Llevamos casi más de 60 años en este estilo de baile bailando.
And we've been dancing this style probably for 60 years or more.
Sin embargo, contra todo pronóstico, y sin embargo, hoy día se ha ido enriqueciendo mucho más.
And against all odds, we just kept doing it, and we feel like every day it just keeps getting enriched and becoming more and more.
Este estilo de baile se enriquece porque no es baile de nosotros, no es casino de los cubanos solo. Es baile de todos ustedes, porque todos ustedes al bailar, a crear una figura nueva, pues va enriqueciendo este estilo de baile. Y por lo tanto, nosotros nos sentimos muy contentos y muy orgullosos de ver el baile que nosotros, de 2011, nosotros estamos bailando la fiesta de baile. Y que hoy día lo bailan internacionalmente en todo el mundo, se baila este estilo de baile.
So we're just so pleased because it's like every day, not just us anymore. It's not just the dance of Cubans anymore. Like all over the world, people like you are creating new things every day. Like everyone creates a new move or a new movement. And so each day it's getting richer and richer because of people like you. And we're just so pleased just to imagine that this is happening from something that we did when we were 11 or 12 years old. Like something that we just started playing with and thinking about. And now it's this big worldwide
phenomenon. Esto es una historia muy larga, ¿no? En la cual han participado muchas personas, porque en realidad la música tiene una diferencia con la danza.
So I do want to mention that this is the history of Casino is a very long history, that many, many people have participated in it, not just the first ones who created it. Because we're talking about the creation of a style of dance and really the creation eventually of a genre of music. So many, many people are part of this history.
En la música, un compositor crea una obra y se le reconocida. Por ejemplo, cuando hablamos de mambo, Damaso Pérez Prado es cubano.
So what usually happened is that there would be a musician who would create a work of art, like Damaso Pérez Prado, who created the first song and will say it's mambo. And so then everybody knows the mambo thanks to him.
Cha-cha-cha, Enrique Jorrín.
And so then we have the same type of situation with cha-cha-cha and Enrique Jorrín.
Etcétera, etcétera. Ahora, en el baile, en este estilo de baile, en realidad, influye muchos factores, muchas personas, nosotros, ustedes, los fundadores. Y bueno, también voy a estar en este momento a aprovechar de que nosotros estamos aquí sentados compartiendo con ustedes y hemos compartido en muchas reuniones con muchos grupos que han venido de diferentes partes del mundo a conversar, a interesarse por la historia. No quiero dejar pasar por alto que nosotros, hay muchas personas que han trabajado muy fuerte en esto, nosotros, etcétera. Pero gracias a este señor que está aquí, que se llama Juan Gómez, a él no le gusta que lo mencione, que se llama Juan Gómez, él es el abuelo. No porque sea viejito, sino porque tiene una cana aquí de niño. Pues nosotros estamos aquí sentados, ya que él en realidad siempre ha estado al lado de este estilo de baile en Cuba, ha sido una persona que más ha trabajado, porque nosotros que somos la historia, somos los testigos. Cuando usted va a averiguar algo acerca de una historia, tiene que ir a los participantes, los que participaron activamente. Y nosotros, como fundadores, todos nosotros, no solo, nos damos cuenta que la persona que más ha estado, o sea, al lado de este estilo de baile, muchas cosas que yo se las puedo nombrar, en competencia de baile, programa de televisión, etcétera, etcétera. ¿Qué más ha estado activo? En Cuba, para nosotros, se llama Juan Gómez. El abuelo. Ese que está aquí al lado.
Bien hecho.
Un aplauso para la amiga.
So there were kind of two sections in what he was talking about. So the first section was that you have these other styles of dance that are created by a musician, and then there's kind of a dance that goes along with it, and it's solidified and it's done in a certain way, so you know what it is exactly you're supposed to do. But in this case, you can't give credit to any one person. There's a whole bunch of dancers who started creating it, and then a whole bunch more dancers who kept enriching it, and then musicians who started to create new music following the dancers. So you can't give credit to one person. It's like a work, it's a masterpiece of many, many people enriching the process to create the dance. So that was the first section of what he was talking about. And then he said the second section is that for him and for the other founders, it's an honor to keep having people like you come and visit and learn about the history. But that really it's important to him to acknowledge, and that he thinks everyone feels the same way, that we wouldn't be here sitting and talking about this history, even though all of them contributed, so many people contributed, except for that Juan Gómez keeps sharing the story, keeps making sure it gets out there, keeps promoting it. He has dance competitions, he had events, he's making sure that people know about Casino. So he just wants to make sure that you guys know how thankful that he is and the other founders are that Juanito keeps doing this. And he also wants you to know that he is not el abuelo because of his age, but that when he was very young, he had some white hairs on the side. So from that time, they always called him Juanito el abuelo.
Si yo mira, en realidad, hay varias razones por las cuales sentirse orgulloso, ¿no?
So there's many reasons that we can be proud.
Primero por lo que está pasando en el mundo hoy.
First because of what's happening in the world today.
Como decía Luis, era muy difícil para nosotros imaginar que aquellos que hicimos por divertirnos, por estar juntos la juventud, se hubiera convertido en un fenómeno mundial como hoy la rueda de Casino y el estilo.
So like Luis said, it's very hard for us to imagine when we were kids, or even as we look back at being kids, that the thing we did just to play around and have fun would end up becoming a worldwide phenomenon.
También igual, orgulloso porque Luis, contemporáneo conmigo, tenemos exactamente la misma edad. sea capaz de decir una cosa como esta, o que lo diga cualquiera de nosotros fundadores, también es un elemento de orgullo personal para mí.
So it's also a personal honor for me to have someone like Luis, who's actually the exact same age as me, who's been dancing all this time, to say something like he just said about me. So that's a personal honor for me.
Ahora, tengo que dejar constancia que el casino, lo mismo el baile que la rueda, es un hecho absolutamente colectivo. No es que yo inventé nada. A lo mejor puse un granito de arena en algunas cosas, como el oso también influyó en algunas cosas, como el propio Luis o Babi pudieron haber influido, pero esto es simplemente un movimiento colectivo, un movimiento de muchas personas pensando, de muchas personas en su momento creando pasos. Por tanto, para mí es colectivo, no es que...
I think that I want to go into what Luis was starting to get at before he talked about me, and then really put in what I think about this. One thing that's special about Casino is that it wasn't made by one person. It wasn't made by me, and really nobody can say that they invented it. It was a work of a collective. It was many people working together. And maybe I put in a little grain of sand somewhere, but so did El Oso, and so did Luis, and so did so many other people. So when we look back at what is the history of Casino, we want you to look at it that it was invented by a collective of people.
Él empezó por una parte que ahora quiero, me doy cuenta que la dejé un poco atrás y que es una cosa bien importante que ustedes conozcan.
So he started in a direction that we kind of left to the side, but it's really important, so I want to talk about it.
¿Cómo pasó de 20-something personas bailando esto a convertirse en un fenómeno nacional?
So let's talk about how it went from like 20-something people dancing this to become a national phenomenon.
Si no hubiera habido una revolución, no hubiera pasado esto.
So I have to say that if there had not been a revolution, particularly at that moment, that we wouldn't have had this happen with Rueda y Casino.
Yo no voy a hacer nunca un discurso político porque yo no soy un político.
So I'm never going to make a political speech because I'm not a politician.
De eso no quiere decir que uno pueda negar realidades.
But at the same time, we can't negate the facts about what happened historically.
El triunfo de la revolución nos cambió completamente.
The triumph of the revolution changed our country completely.
A todos nosotros.
To every person in it.
Nosotros, el triunfo de la revolución, y lo digo por mí mismo, sin sacar la cuenta de él, pero teníamos 12 años con el triunfo de la revolución. 12.
I'll say it for me, but I'll say it for him, I'll say it for almost anyone. And like for us, we were only 12 at the time of the revolution.
Pero simplemente la revolución cambia todo. Y es un hecho que tuvo una influencia en lo cultural inmenso, pero en lo social, en lo económico, en todo.
And so the revolution had a complete impact on like what was happening for us socially, culturally, politically, every aspect of life economically was changed by the revolution.
Esto, repito, no es un discurso que estoy haciendo de que la gente esté de acuerdo completamente conmigo. Cada uno puede tener su opinión. Yo digo la sensación que tenemos nosotros.
So, I'm not making political speech, and I'm not actually even talking about who agrees or disagrees with me. I'm just looking at factually for us what we saw happen.
El problema está que estábamos en el casino deportivo, ahí lo dejamos, ¿verdad? 20-something personas bailando casino, ahora.
So we had left the story, remember, in the casino deportivo, 20-something people dancing casino.
¿Cómo eso pudo trascender este pequeño espacio que era el casino deportivo de La Habana?
So how could that transcend this tiny space that was a private club, Casino Deportivo de La Habana?
Porque simplemente yo, en esa misma edad que estoy diciendo, el triunfo de la revolución, yo con 13 años me fui a alfabetizar a la Sierra Maestra.
Well, let's talk about me, for example. After the triumph of the revolution, when I was just 13 years old, I went out into the highest mountain range, the Sierra Maestra, to teach people how to read and write.
Luis hizo otro tanto antes o después.
A los 13 años que estaba enseñando.
Sí, sí. Y en la Sierra Maestra.
Increíble.
And he was teaching reading and writing at the age of 13 in the tallest mountain, the Sierra Maestra, that was right outside of Santiago, that we all passed through. And Luis went to Pinar del Río, which is the absolute opposite side of the country, at the same age. So you guys are starting to see how Rueda spread already, right?
Es muy difícil comprender exactamente cuál ha sido la vida de los cubanos viviendo en Cuba.
So it might be difficult to comprehend what the life had been of Cubans living in Cuba.
Con 13 años fuimos hombres, fuimos mujeres.
But at 13 years, we all became men and women.
Y eso nos mató para siempre.
This impacted us for life.
Por eso se pudo simplemente, pudo llegar el casino a ser un fenómeno nacional. Simplemente porque nosotros nos fuimos a alfabetizar nos íbamos a las zafras completas en el campo, porque no había suficiente mano para tratar de hacer una zafra buena y poder salir nosotros del subdesarrollo que teníamos.
So it was because everybody was going out into the countryside because there weren't enough hands to complete the harvest. There weren't enough people to teach to read and write. So all of us here were going out.
Nadie nos obligó.
And nobody obligated us to go.
Bueno, no tengan duda ustedes que todo buen cubano que pensó en su país, que pensó en el de frente, en el de al lado, en el pobre, en la mujer, en el negro, en el rico, que pensamos en todo el mundo. Todo buen cubano que pudo pensar eso, alfabetizó como yo, o se fue a la zafra como yo, o a la recogida de papa, o a cualquier actividad que había que hacer en ese momento, donde no ganábamos un centavo y donde lo hacíamos voluntario, absolutamente voluntario. Era un placer, no solamente era un deber, es que era un placer para uno hacerlo sabiendo de que eso podía ayudar al desarrollo del país.
So for all of us, it was this feeling not only of responsibility but also of pleasure to be able to help everyone in our country. So he said every person who was like a thinking good human being had this moment of realization that if we all did something together at the same time, we could change the life of everybody in the country. And so everybody who was thinking about not just himself, but also the person next to him, whether they were young or old or poor or rich or black or white or in the country or in the city, that everybody was trying to figure out a way to help. So people went to help with sugarcane harvest, people went to help with literacy, people went to help with just growing food, building, anything that somebody could help with. Even the youngest people, like they said they were 12 and 13 years old when they went, were going out to see how they could be of help, and everything was volunteer work, like nobody was charging for it. And so that created a great amount of movement across the country from here going out.
Por tanto, un proceso que nosotros nos llevamos nuestra cultura, nosotros nos llevamos nuestro baile para cualquier otra parte del país. Pero cuánta gente por ahí, de los más pobres, hasta de la Sierra Maestra donde yo fabricé, después vinieron a estudiar a La Habana.
So of course we're looking at that when we went out to help in whatever way we could, didn't just teach literacy and didn't just harvest. We brought with us what was our favorite dance, what was our culture from in the city, what we wanted to share was this dance. And then how many poor people who would never have in their life dreamed of coming to the city, came to the city to study in the university, right where this dance was being born.
Por tanto, eso nos hizo simplemente que en muy poco tiempo se lograra que se pudiera decir que en el país entero se bailaba casino.
So it made it happen that in a very short period of time, with all this movement of people, of humans from the country to the city and the city to the country, that the entire country was dancing casino in a fairly or relatively short period of time.
Pero también lo mismo en la campaña de alfabetización, que en cualquier trabajo voluntario, que hasta a veces en la trinchera, teníamos al lado una mujer, un negro, un chino. ¿Qué tiempo teníamos nosotros de pensar en las razas cuando estábamos a punto?
So, what is so interesting when I look back and I think about this is, for example, when we were in the literacy campaign, teaching the people in the poorest places to read and write, or when we were working in the trenches, whatever it was we were doing, we were like working for survival of ourselves and our country, and there was no moment to think about, oh, this guy's black, this guy's Chinese, this guy's white. It was like all of us together, and we had to do it.
Esa es la razón por la cual, ¿qué les voy a decir? A mí me hablan de negro, no lo veo.
That's why people talk to me about races like black or white, and I don't see it. I just talk to people about Cubans. We're all Cubans.
Y esa es la integración que tenemos. Ustedes lo verán constantemente. O sea, nadie piensa si este es negro, si es blanco, si es chino, si es mujer o si es hombre. Todo el mundo siempre tenga la capacidad para hacer una cosa, la hace.
So this is an integration that happened and a change that happened dramatically after the revolution, is that we don't think about like these people for this, these people for this. It's just there's a job to do and there's someone to do it. It doesn't matter if they're white or black or male or female. It's just we all get the job done.
Discúlpenme ustedes que en algún momento pues me sale un poco la pasión.
I'm really sorry that I'm like getting emotional. So I'm sorry that there's moments that my passion for this comes out when I'm talking.
pero si no hablo de estas cosas, ¿cómo poder explicarlo en casino? O sea,
but if I don't talk about these things, how is it possible that you could understand the history of what happened with casino?
Porque un baile es política, la música es política, la vida es política.
Because even though he's not talking politics, he realizes that this dance, in the form it is, that it was spread as a collective, is something political. And that the music and the way that it was developed is something political. And everything in life, in some way, is political. So he's not talking politics, but he's talking about the impact of politics in daily life.
Tanto todo aquel que se fue de Cuba en un determinado momento, para mí sigue siendo cubano.
And for me, everyone who left Cuba in some undetermined moment still is Cuban.
Porque no hay nada que marque que una persona nacida en un país no sea de ese país. Por tanto, yo sigo y tengo mi propia opinión sobre las cosas, pero hay muchísima gente en mi generación. Normalmente la gente piensa de esta manera. Estoy seguro que estoy hablando esto y que es la misma opinión de Luis. Simplemente somos cubanos. Una raza diferente, no. Un país que nos tocó un determinado momento histórico, que nos tocó un momento determinado de afrontar determinadas cosas. Y así lo hicimos. A lo mejor equivocado, pienso yo que no. Así lo hicimos.
Okay, so he said, and you know, I think that whoever was born in this country is still Cuban. And I think that we all had this big thing that happened all at once, this historical moment, probably different than anywhere else in the world. And it was like that moment kind of is what made us all Cuban. Like there was not the ability to keep the same racial divisions or gender divisions after that moment, because everything was changed. And no matter what somebody believes now or then, if you agree with his opinion or disagree, that that moment changed the country forever, and that this dance is part of that.
Yo, si hay algo que quieras preguntar en este sentido, pues perfecto, pero yo preferiría pasar a otro tema.
So
o este mismo tema, pero de otra manera y por otro lado.
So he said that he's open to answering questions because he doesn't know if he should keep going in the same direction or that he could talk about this maybe from a different direction, but he is open for questions and all of that.
¿Cómo podernos ocupar de eso? ¿O cómo podernos ocupar de promocionar un baile?
Sí.
Cuando aquí, si había 3 pesos, era para invertirlo en comida y que la gente pudiera comer.
Pero todavía pasó eso todo. So I asked him about something that he talks about a lot, but because we took questions so early, we kind of went in different angles today than we usually do. And he says it's very important to mention right now, and he asked me to explain it, which is that there's a little key piece of the fact that the dance spread so fast that is kind of important to note, which is that there really aren't any videos of this dance. I mean, until now, obviously, but like from back then, it was completely this little group of young people, and then more people who moved to the city to study and then picked it up in that area, like the rest of the city who came to these places, the people who went out into the country to teach, but it was all moving mouth to mouth. It wasn't like people were seeing this new way of dancing on TV the way they did with other things like Mambo Cha-Cha-Cha that had like a commercialization or a record company behind it, right? They were promoting a new genre, promoting a new style. They just came up with a way to dance. They could do it to any style of music, mambo, son, rock and roll, cha-cha-cha. Whatever type of music played, they could dance in the casino way. And so there was no reason for any musicians or band to promote it. But even though that was the case, the next thing you know, the musicians are following them and trying to create music that they will want to dance to. And next thing you know, just mouth to mouth, the whole country in... Nosotros decimos como menos que 10 años, ¿verdad? Menos que 10 años, el país entero está bailando casino.
Sí, menos de 10 años. Posiblemente entre 10 y 15, por ahí debe andar. No preciso, porque tampoco yo puedo decir que precisamente. Pero sí, menos de 15 años.
It's hard to be precise about exactly how long it took, but we'll say, to be sure, less than 15 years, maybe even less than 10, or somewhere in there. It was like the entire country could dance casino, and it had never been promoted, never been seen on TV, never been in the newspaper, never been on the radio. It was just something kids were doing and spreading as they were teaching or as they were going to the sugarcane harvest or wherever they were going. So that's like a really key part of the story, because how did that possibly happen? Well, it just happened mouth to mouth.
Yo también tengo que decir por ahí, porque el casino podemos decir que es una pasión nacional.
So we can say that casino is like our national passion.
Más allá de que hay gente que lo reconozca, gente que no, gente que de pronto no quisiera oír el nombre casino porque a lo mejor le perjudica lo que ellos quisieran hacer.
So maybe there's people who don't want to hear about casino because maybe prejudice against what they want to do, like if they want to create something new.
El problema es que todo el mundo tiene necesidad de inventar. Y esto ya está inventado.
Everybody wants to invent new things, but this now is already invented.
Ahora lo que sí, les puedo también decir que hay una historia linda también. Cuando se empieza a formar la salsa o el movimiento salsero.
But I can say that there's a beautiful story that occurs too as the salsa movement begins in the United States.
Es el momento, por supuesto, que se ha ido de Cuba Celia Cruz, que se ha ido de Cuba la Sonora Matancera.
So it's the moment that, of course, we have Celia Cruz has now left Cuba, Sonora Matancera has now left Cuba.
Había también algunos cubanos en Estados Unidos como Moco Santa María o Machito.
There were also some Cubans who were in the United States at the time of the revolution, like Machito and like Mongo Santa María.
Que ya estaban haciendo lo suyo desde antes. Pérez Prado incluso estuvo en Estados Unidos mucho tiempo.
Pérez Prado had his time in the United States. Like all of these artists who were already working in the U.S. before the revolution as well.
Pero simplemente la presencia de Celia Cruz y la Sonora Matancera, unido con este movimiento que ya venía desde un poco antes allá, de lo tropical, de lo latino, para mucha gente sí, identificando a los cubanos también. Pero este movimiento hizo que algunas personas, inteligentes por supuesto, crearan todo un movimiento desde el punto de vista comercial, que se le llamó salsa. Tiene que ver también mucho con una marca discográfica, Fania, que lo hizo Jerry Masucci. Y ahí incluyó a algunos latinos, pero sobre todo los cubanos, que estaban en todas partes del mundo.
So when we talk about the salsa movement, we are talking about that there were already Cuban artists in the United States. But then when Celia Cruz and Sonora Matancera left, you start to have this feeling that the important artists are now based in the U.S. or even more primarily based in New York. And someone who is, of course, very intelligent, Jerry Masucci, who ran Fania Records, took advantage of that moment. There had already been a little movement into people liking what was tropical and especially liking what was Cuban. So he capitalized on that, got the Cuban artists that he could and the tropical artists that were there, and started to create what would become Fania or the salsa movement in the United States.
Ojo, porque quiero decir y aclarar desde de antemano que para los latinos la salsa fue de vital importancia.
So let me just say before I go into everything else that for Latinos in the world that salsa was of vital importance.
Porque fue un punto de unión.
Because it was a point of union or unity.
Fue un punto también importante de sentirse que lo que ellos hacían era reconocido.
It was also a very important way to make help Latinos feel that what they did or what they enjoyed was important, was recognized.
Más allá del traspatio político que esto podía tener cuando se silenciaba a los cubanos o cuando se decía que el son se había ido de Cuba.
And that was even more important, that union of Latinos, than what we see as the political move, which was kind of to silence Cuba through the blockade and to start stating that music and dance had left Cuba.
Estoy hablando de esto, que el son se fue de Cuba, fue en el momento que se fue Celia, sin tener en cuenta que se quedó Benny Morey.
So people started saying like son has left Cuba because Celia left, without remembering that Benny Morey had stayed.
O se quedó Tito Gómez, o se quedó Orestes Macías, o tantos otros que siguieron en Cuba y no se fue.
Or like all the many who stayed in Cuba, like Orestes Macías, like Tito Gómez, like all the people who stayed here, as if they didn't exist. But of course they did.
Lo malo no era la creación de la salsa, eso hasta estuvo bien y fue una operación interesante, muy interesante, más allá de los intereses económicos que había. Lo peor fue tratar, desde el punto de vista político, de aislar a Cuba y dejar a Cuba fuera de todo eso. Eso fue lo peor.
So we don't think that the creation of salsa, or even the way it was created, was bad. We know that it had a commercial intent, and that's okay sometimes. I think that it was good because it was a point of unity. There were lots of good things that salsa did. But what was bad is that it was sometimes utilized as an additional way to isolate Cuba and try to push Cuba out of what would be the salsa movement.
Ahora, ¿cuánto nosotros podíamos haber invertido en promocionar el casino o el son cubano. En realidad no podíamos invertir nada, cero.
But now let's get real. How much at that moment in history, right after the revolution, could we have actually invested in the promotion of son or salsa music or Latino music? Honestly, nothing. No money could have been invested.
Pero sin embargo, esto que desde el punto de vista político fue muy negativo, but, que confundió a mucha gente, sobre todo a muchos latinos.
But this thing that happened, that from a political perspective at the time was very bad, because it confused a lot of people, it confused a lot of Latinos, it blocked us out in a lot of ways.
Sin embargo, fue el motor impulsor, usted no tenga duda que el motor impulsor para llegar el son cubano o la música cubana o la rueda de casino, y el casino fue la salsa.
But that commercial venture that was salsa was the motor that made it possible for son or casino or anything else Cuban to then be brought to the rest of the world.
Porque en la salsa se invirtió dinero. La salsa llegó a Europa sin que hubiera llegado fuertemente la música cubana, más allá del cha-cha-cha, más allá del mambo. Y todavía en Europa le decían chacha en vez de cha-cha-cha.
Because salsa was invested in. It had a major commercial investment and it was even brought to Europe. And it became huge in ways that even mambo and cha-cha-cha never could have. In fact, in Europe, they now say cha-cha instead of cha-cha-cha.
Por tanto, la salsa llamó la atención de que había algo más que el rock, que los ingleses, que los americanos haciendo música, so, más allá de los brasileños que también han tenido una presencia mundial.
Salsa brought attention to what was happening in addition to the rock and roll that British and Americans were doing, in addition to the music from Brazil. Salsa brought attention to what Latinos were doing, and it called attention to, again, create a phenomenon backed by a commercial venture, but still really showcasing the work of Cuban.
El problema es que cuando de pronto llega la rueda de casino no había nada que hacer, porque todo el mundo sabía que eso no tenía nada que ver con la salsa. Rueda de casino, lo dice el nombre.
But then when people started noticing the rueda de casino, there was no way to hide Cuba's influence, because the name says it all. It was rueda de casino. There was never a rueda de salsa.
La gente empieza a comprender que detrás de la salsa hay otras cosas que no saben.
So through the rueda de casino, people start to realize that there's some things behind salsa that they don't yet know about.
Hay cubanos en todas partes del mundo.
There's Cubans all over the world.
Por razones diferentes.
For all for different reasons.
Ni siquiera para mí es importante eso.
That isn't what's important, what the reasons are.
Seguida termina, porque si no corto la idea, me queda un pedacito. El problema está que cuando la gente descubre que hay algo más de eso y empiezan los cubanos que están en todas partes a bailar el casino, de pronto se dan cuenta que es igual pero es diferente.
So that's what happens, is that people start to notice, like the Cubans in different places start to dance and they say, well, like that's the same, that's like salsa, but still there's something different. And so they're noticing that something different that makes them want to investigate, study the roots, leads them to Cuba.
La salsa siempre en las escuelas, sobre todo en Europa, más que para acá, que la salsa es más cercana y más vista constantemente en nuestros países, pero sobre todo en Europa se estableció todo un régimen de escuelas, por un producto lógicamente de la necesidad económica de la gente de sobrevivir, donde casi todas las cosas que se hacían eran prácticamente obligadas. O sea, usted tenía que bailar de esta manera para ser salsero, las manos por la cabeza, por ejemplo, este tipo de cosas que se impusieron prácticamente en las escuelas en Europa. De pronto llegan los cubanos y se cagan en la mano en la cabeza, no hay mano en la cabeza, y la gente empieza a disfrutar desde el punto de vista del corazón, no solamente de los pies, el baile. Porque en eso somos maestros, ¿eh? En disfrutar el baile somos maestros, no hay duda.
Okay, so in Europe, I think for economic reasons, it created a huge economy of scale that was supported a lot of people. There became salsa schools. It's schools that taught that there was one way to do things. Like, for example, that in salsa, there was a certain way to pass your hand over your head. And so that people learned, like, this is the only way to do it. He said this is more in Europe than the United States, because in the United States, people could see Latinos, like they were closer and they could see it. But in Europe, it was like the way the school says, and that's it. But then they started to see Cubans dancing, and then they didn't pass their hand over their head, so they were like, huh, like, so what's this? What's going on? And he said, if people noticed that sometimes that the Cubans were really enjoying the dance more, and he said, because if you want to say we're masters of anything, we're masters of enjoying our dances. So that's where he left off.
Es un poco la historia, o sea, en el sentido concreto de lo que nos ha pasado, a la larga y a la corta, la salsa nos sirvió.
So that's a little bit of our story. I mean, however you want to look at it now, at least with hindsight, at the end of things, salsa has helped us. Although before, there might have been some resentment. So this guy wants to talk. Hold on.
Por favor.
Tengo 36 años, fui pelotero hasta los 22 y me inicié en esto de baile, de la clase, a los 24 y medio. So, llevo 12 años solamente dándole caña a esto, estudiando y todo esto. Y yo pude darme cuenta de que el estilo de ustedes simplemente marcó una trayectoria muy importante, porque yo inicié en el 1 bailando línea, luego en 2. Y es verdad que cuando tú bailas una canción de 4 minutos con la misma persona, tienes que esperar a otra canción para bailar con una sola persona, eso es lo que te lleva a entender que cuando tú ves casino o rueda, tú dices, esta gente disfruta más que uno, porque óyeme, yo en una misma canción bailo con 10 mujeres y me disfruto y gozo. ¿Puedes traducir esa parte, por favor?
Ay, yo lo voy a traducir.
Sí.
Ay, yo pensé que tú te ibas a traducir.
No.
All right. So, I wasn't listening with my translating hat, I was listening with my human being hat, but I will give it a try. So he says, I'm 36 years old, and I was a professional baseball player till I was 22. So I only had 12 years in this like world, being a dancer, being a teacher, training really hard. And you know, first I did on one, then I did on two, but then I noticed with humans that there was something else. Because like me, I might dance one whole song with a girl, I might get a little bored as I was in the line, and then I saw Rey de Casino and I was like, I could dance with 10 girls in one song. And he said that he liked that. ¿Lo traduje bien?
Muy bien, muy bien. So, entonces, me dije a mí mismo, lo digo, estoy hablando para que él escuche, luego traducirle a ellos, para que vea la importancia de su creación hoy en día. Me dije a mí mismo, en mi escuela yo quiero enseñar no solo línea on one on two, yo quiero enseñar cubano, porque yo quiero que mis clientes cuando vengan de Europa puedan bailar con los dominicanos que han aprendido aquí en mi escuela en uno, en dos, y mezclarlo con lo que es la rueda. Y eso es lo que yo he hecho. Allá yo hago rueda en dos, yo hago rueda en uno, o sea que sería rueda en son montuno, ¿verdad? Y sería, y rueda en el tiempo uno que bailamos LA, Los Ángeles, algo así. Pero voy a explicar eso. So, my idea was like try to convince the Dominican people not only to dance on one or on two, but also be able to mix dance like Cuban salsa as a rueda on two on one, to be able to like have more fun and make the tourist people, once they arrive to my country, to have more fun too, not only dance on one and on two, but sometimes it becomes like a little boring. Just dance one on one on one, online, online, online. I don't give a shit. How many times should I be dancing like that or like that? I just like to turn around, make, you know, the lady feel happy. And my dancer, my animator, the ladies, they should make, what's your name? Seth?
Where's the question, bro? Yes? Where's the question?
Javier or Matthew or Joel.
¿Quieren saber la pregunta?
Has fun.
¿Qué es la pregunta?
¿La pregunta?
No,
es una pregunta.
Es comentario.
No, it's not a question. No. Like, you know, like, letting he know how important is for me and it was, you know, like 10 years ago.
Solamente quería
dejarte saber. Yo sí le tengo una pregunta.
That's all.
Yo tengo una pregunta.
De todas maneras, miren, a mí me parece muy bien que él, por ejemplo, haya pensado en este derrotero que de pronto lo hace cambiar un poco, hasta donde él ha trabajado.
So I think it's really interesting too for me to hear like what he's done and the way he's working.
Yo siempre soy de los que digo, no coinciden todos los fundadores en esto. Hay fundadores que tienen otro criterio.
Not all the founders of a group, what I'm about to say, some people have a little bit different opinion.
Porque hay fundadores que tienen un esquema. Este no sabe dar derecha e izquierda. Este no sabe hacer esto y entonces ya eso no es casino puro. Hay fundadores que tienen esa idea, so, de los mismos que trabajan conmigo, fíjate.
So even in our little group, there's some people who like, there's a move that they don't know how to do, and so then they're like, well, that's not real casino, that's not traditional casino. So there's some people in his group that feel that way, that if it's not the thing that they know, that it's not really casino.
Para mí, te vuelvo a pedir...
No, tranquilo.
...para poder terminar de desarrollar lo que quiero decir. Para mí, que siempre yo digo que el casino que se baila de verdad es el que usted hace con el corazón y no con los pies.
But since I always say that the casino that's true is the one that you dance with your heart and not the one that you dance with your feet.
A mí, en realidad, me sirve toda la gente que tenga la intención de hacer esto, porque por eso el casino se ha vuelto una cosa grande e importante en el mundo.
So for me, I actually appreciate all the versions of casino. Everyone who has the intention, the heart to try something in casino, I appreciate all of it because that's what's enriched casino to be where it is in the world.
Yo siempre digo, haga usted su casino, que ese es el que usted necesita.
So I always say, make your casino, that's the one that you need.
No es el casino que hago yo, porque finalmente a lo mejor no te llega de la misma manera que tú mismo eres capaz de crear.
And I see that don't do the casino that I do, because maybe that won't come to you in the same way that the casino you are able to create.
Por tanto, yo vivo muy agradecido a toda la gente que hoy en el mundo hace este trabajo.
So I live full of gratitude for all the people in the world who do casino, who create a casino, and who make it possible for me to do what I do.
De una manera o de otra, o sintiéndolo en el tiempo uno, en el dos, o como sea, no importa.
So whether you feel it on the one, on the two, or whatever, it doesn't matter.
Para mí más tiene que ver la intención, las ganas, la posibilidad de comunicar eso que uno tiene adentro.
So what's more important to me is like the intention that you give it, the strong desire that you have, the ability that you have to transmit your emotions or that feeling when you're dancing.
Siempre cuando usted no sea un mercenario. Lo que no me gusta es los mercenarios que hacen esto solamente por el hecho de ganar una plata sin sentir lo que están haciendo. Usted tiene que ganar la plata, usted trabaja en esto, tiene que ganar la plata, pero ahora, si usted cree verdaderamente en esto, si usted lo siente como suyo, haga usted su casino, no hay ningún problema, no vamos a tener nunca contradicciones, porque el casino no es una cosa esquemática, el casino es simplemente el casino que usted piensa, que usted siente, el casino que usted necesita. No lo haga de manera mercenaria, solamente eso pido.
The only thing that bothers him is that some people do it as what he calls as mercenaries. So that they learn the style and that they teach it in a strict way just to make money. So they are creating a school and a technique just to make money. And he says that that bothers him. He said what doesn't bother him is that when somebody feels the music and with everything that they're feeling, that they have a different way of moving or a different way of dancing casino, then he thinks that that's wonderful. He wants everyone to make their own casino and enjoy it in the way that they feel it, and that that's what's going to keep enriching it. And he said, but please don't be mercenaries. Don't just have a technique and teach it to make money like some of the schools are.
Más allá que hay esenciales mínimos que usted debe respetar.
He said, but of course there's a few basic things that people should respect in terms of what is casino.
Va en su reflejo de la verdad, va en su personalidad, va en cuánto sincero usted es o no.
And it's important that of how you reflect reality, how you reflect the truth, if you're being sincere about your understanding of casino, all of that's important too.
Sí, tengo por ahí todavía
preguntas. La pregunta mía es muy breve. Dale.
Que estaba hablando hace un tiempo ahora, pero estaban hablando de que vamos a ver el casino en la rueda tradicional. Y yo quería saber, como por la pregunta del chufla, que era algo de 80 y 90, ¿a qué época acabó la rueda tradicional? Y si en los años 80 o 90 siguieron ustedes bailando tradicionalmente, o si ustedes bailaron el casino y la rueda del 80 y...
Espérate, para...
I can self-translate. So my question was that earlier we were talking about the different styles and when they came about, and how like in Echeverria, for example, was from the 80s and 90s. My question is, when did like the traditional time period end, and if in the 80s and 90s, this group continued dancing their traditional style, or if they picked up the young kid styles of the 80s and 90s?
Mira, después va a continuar Luis porque también tenemos la misma apreciación, pero hay un par de cosillas ahí que me interesa mucho precisar porque es parte importante de esto que estamos
haciendo. You're going to say something that Luis is going to continue. He's going to focus on the things that are most important.
Para mí, casino clásico es una época.
So for me, classic casino is a specific era.
No pretendemos para nada que la gente continúe haciendo lo mismo.
So there are, of course, people who continue doing the same style.
Todos los movimientos, todas las figuras que después se han hecho en la rueda, bienvenidas sean.
So all the figures that they made afterwards in the rueda are also still welcome.
En los 80, los 90, como ahora también, ya después del 2000, cada uno ha inventado cosas diferentes.
In the 80s and 90s, and then again now, after the 2000s, lots of people have invented new things.
Que más que nada, para mí, la importancia que esto puede tener es que se siga desarrollando el casino.
And for me, the most important thing that has happened with all of this is that casino continues developing.
La música cambió.
The music changed.
Las influencias del ambiente, de la guerra, de la paz o de lo que sea,
the influences of war, of different things in different parts of the world have changed the dance.
Estoy seguro que tú y yo, que somos dos humanos, tú eres de ascendencia cubana, sí. Por casualidad, me imaginé, y tú también. Wow. Lo sentí mucho. Pero seguramente...
He's guessing that they're of Cuban descent. Is that true? And they both said yes. He said, I can tell, I can feel it.
Seguramente tú ves la vida de una manera y yo la veo de otra. Y no por problemas políticos.
And it could be that you guys see the world and life in one way and me in another way and not because of politics.
Se trata simplemente de que la gente hoy vive con un conjunto de influencias, con un conjunto de cosas diferentes que te influyen. Yo el celular lo uso para llamar y solamente para eso. Yo no sé usar más el celular.
It's because all of you guys are living in a world with a whole different set of influences than was mine. Except for like this phone, for example, in my pocket, I just use it for calls and that's it. Nothing else with the cellular phone.
Y en la computadora tengo que llamar constantemente a mi esposa, que es bastante más joven que yo.
And with the computer, I have to keep calling my wife over because she's a lot younger than me.
Porque si no, no pudiera hacer nada. Soy
without
bien sincero,
her, I wouldn't be able to do anything.
Por eso te digo, o sea, la importancia aquí no es exactamente la clasificación, en mi opinión la desclasificación es más importante, porque eso es lo que masifica, eso es lo que llega a que un japonés sienta que bailar casino es importante.
So what's important to me, actually much more than the classification of what exactly is casino, is the declassification. Because through declassification, you are able to include the masses in what is casino. And that's what makes it possible for someone in Japan to be able to dance casino and really feel it in their own way.
O sea, que si tú vas a clasificar, hay clasificaciones, por supuesto. O sea, una cosa fueron los 80, otra cosa los 90, so, otra cosa son los 2000 ahora.
So, of course, there are classifications. There was something in the 80s, something in the 90s, and now the 2000s, but...
Y veo gente bailando en tiempo de reggaetón y hacer la rueda.
And I see people doing rueda to reggaetón.
Salsatón. No hay tantos tones por ahí.
Oh, casi.
He said there's so many tones around here now. Salsatón, reggaetón is a lot.
Pero como quiera, para mí lo importante es la esencia. Una esencia verdadera, sincera, grata. Para mí el casino clásico siempre tendrá que ser aquel del inicio. Por eso no hemos cambiado los pasos en la rueda.
Pero para seguir, que ahora ustedes van a como bailar en una manera tradicional. Ajá. Si salen mañana a bailar, ¿van a bailar en esa manera o van a hacer lo que bailan la gente ahora?
Es Luis's turn.
Yo le voy a aclarar bien la pregunta porque yo sí le copié bien.
So I got your question really well.
Mira, desde el nacimiento de este estilo de baile en el año 50 y pico, por ahí, hasta el año 1964, que es cuando se consolidó ya en Cuba y se conoció el mundo, el baile casino estaba consolidado.
Okay, so we'll say that from the start, somewhere in the 1950s, we often pinpoint 56, 57, when casino started, up until, say, 1964, we can say that by that time, casino was consolidated as a style.
Cualquier buen bailador en Cuba podía bailar diferentes ruedas. Por ejemplo, si yo vivía aquí en playa, yo podía bailar en cualquier rueda de casino, en La Habana Vieja, o viviera en cualquier municipio.
So when I say it was consolidated, it was classified up to the point where a good dancer here from playa could really dance in a rueda from Old Havana or other neighborhoods and do fine.
Porque esos eran los pasillos clásicos.
Because we had consolidated the classic steps.
Ahora, después del año 1964, se empiezan a incorporar una serie de nuevas figuras. Entre ellas, las primeras fueron el chufra, la prima, el 70, el chufladole, la etcétera, etcétera, etcétera.
So after 1964 is when they start to incorporate figures, let's say, with names, like el chufla, el chufladole, 70, prima. All of these figures with names, we can say, are coming after 1964.
y se han ido incorporando muchas figuras muy buenas, muy bonitas, muchas evoluciones que ustedes mismos van incorporando, porque por eso decimos que es un casino de todos.
And so there's, and on top of those, there's like lots of more changes, more developments that made it more complex, like all the complicated that we have. He said, and that's the thing that I love, like you guys keep adding to it as you go. Casino is for everyone.
Nosotros que creamos este baile, nos hemos reencontrado en el año 2003, porque también estuvimos mucho tiempo sin bailar.
But so for us, those of us who invented the dance, we didn't get back together again after a long time without dancing until 2003.
Problema de estudio universitario, de
because of studying in the university,
social,
military service,
cosas en el dentista.
And
entonces, posgraduado, etcétera, etcétera.
So I needed time to do my studies, graduate, etc.
Después nos volvimos a reencontrar. Gracias al profesor, como tengo que buscar otro padre, se le gustó
la cultura.
Él no me deja tranquilo.
Entonces nos volvió el bancario. Entonces nos volvió el bancario. Nos metió en
They brought us back together again.
Ahora, nosotros, como fundadores, ¿qué hacemos? Nosotros mantenemos la tradición, las mismas figuras, las mismas figuras que nacieron en el año 57, allá en el antiguo Casino Deportivo de La Habana, que está en Miramar. Esas figuras que se salieron ahí, que se consolidaron, que se unieron con los diferentes bailadores populares, etcétera, etcétera. Después que se limpió su todo, nosotros bailamos esos pasillos.
So now, after we got back together and we decided to make our group the founders, what we are dancing is the moves that came out of the Casino Deportivo right there across the bay, mixed with those that were developed in the years that followed with the dancers from the masses who started to join us, because remember they were just a tiny group before, a specifically selected group based on their class of who could go to the Casino Deportivo. He said in those years, let's say from 1959 to 1964, more was mixed in, and then we put like a stop. These are the passes that we're gonna do, these are the steps that we're gonna do to reflect what is traditional casino.
Verán la diferencia esta noche cuando vengan para acá de la rueda nuestra, como nosotros bailamos, van a ver la diferencia como bailan la rueda los muchachos de ahora nuevos.
So you're going to be able to see how we, the founders, dance the rueda, keeping those old steps alive in comparison to how young people and people today dance the rueda.
Y entonces, una cosa importante, se dan cuenta que nosotros, manteniendo, bailamos un poco, van a ver la diferencia, nosotros bailamos más con los pies en la figura, escuchamos las 12 de mando y bailamos más con los pies que con las manos.
So you're going to notice that we dance a lot more with our feet, we listen to the calls and to the person talking or singing and we follow them, and the people today have names for things and they dance with their hands.
Ahora, cuando estamos solos, cuando estamos bailando en la fiesta solo, etcétera, etcétera, todos nosotros pues sabemos bailar las figuras nuevas.
But all of us, when we're dancing on our own, when we dance with a partner in the parties, we all know how to dance the
old
way. And he says him no, but him yes, he dances all the new moves.
O sea, que si alguno de ustedes quiere bailar 70, la prima con la hermana, el chupa chupador, yo lo puedo hacer con ustedes, una cosa. Porque también bailamos eso.
Say thank, la prima, any of those things, all those new
fangled
moves, you can come and I can dance them with you.
Y muchos pasillos más que,
bueno,
nosotros bailamos, claro que lo bailamos.
¿Habrías preguntado?
Sí, yo.
¿Cuándo has dado cuenta que la red ha salido afuera de Cuba?
When did you notice that Reda had traveled outside of Cuba?
Mira, yo por ejemplo te voy a decir que uno de los responsables que se baile casino en Italia y que se haya desarrollado tanto el casino en Italia soy yo, y te estoy hablando de los años 80 y pico finales.
So I know for me that I would say I'm responsible for a lot of bringing the dance of Reda to Italy. One of the reasons why it has developed so strongly in Italy, and that was in the 1980s.
He abierto escuelas en varias partes, pero sobre todo en Italia particularmente, yo tuve una incidencia grande, ya que mi grupo, pues tocábamos en San Remo, estuvimos en las altas culturas italianas, insertados, haciendo mucha televisión también.
So I've opened schools in different places, but for the most part in Italy, because the musical group that I play with, Moncala, or that I played with, was very important in Italian culture and kind of had a high place in Italian musical culture at that time.
Y eso me hizo pensar que era hora que llegara a Europa el casino más que la salsa.
So I felt like it was important to get casino to Europe, not just salsa. He also said before that he was on television and things like that in Italy.
Y empezamos a abrir escuelas y ya después incluso muchas escuelas de salsa se convirtieron en escuelas de casino.
So he started to open schools for casino and even many salsa schools turned into casino schools.
Yo todavía hoy tengo 9 personas en Italia que fueron alumnos míos.
So I still have 9 people today who were my students who are in Italy teaching.
Incluyendo mi hijo.
Including my son.
Que tiene una escuela grandísima en Roma.
Who has a really big school in Rome.
¿Cuál es su nombre?
Boris Gómez. Te lo encuentras seguramente porque se pasa la vida en Facebook, todo esto.
You can find him online, I think, because he spends his whole life on Facebook and all that stuff.
Me ha abierto además un espacio en Roma que se llama 1830.
Por he even opened a place in Rome called 1830, for obvious reasons.
Y bueno, por ahí estamos. Quiero decirte que ya lleva caminando en el mundo más de 10 años.
So,
incluso, ¿qué te voy a decir? Con un desarrollo que en mi opinión todavía no ha llegado al tope. Ustedes tienen que saber de que la vida es un ciclo. Nada es permanente, nada es estable, nada es suficientemente largo.
So I think that it hasn't yet arrived at the top of where it's going to spread in the world. It's been spreading for many years, but it's going to keep developing.
Estoy hablando de bobería, ahora de pronto dije, por lo menos 10 años, estoy hablando de los años 80 y algo, finales, y en 91, 92, yo tenía unas cuantas escuelas en Italia que yo iba.
So, when we're talking about years, I don't know what I said 10 years for. In the 80s, I was already teaching, and in the 90s, I already knew that I had tons of schools open, so other people did too.
Lacho mental.
Sorry.
Una pregunta, tengo yo entendido que en Cuba no hay leyes fuertes que protegen la propiedad intelectual de muchos artistas. Mi pregunta es, la rueda casino, ¿es considerado un patrimonio de Cuba o Cuba, el gobierno de Cuba le ha hecho un honor a ustedes como los que lo inventaron? The question is,
it is my understanding that here in Cuba they don't have strong intellectual property laws like in other countries, and that I wanted to know if the Rueda de Casino is something that is a patrimony of Cuba, or if the government of Cuba have awarded them with any sort of recognition.
Ahora te explico. La marca, la Rueda de Casino está mi nombre.
So I'll start by saying that the brand or the trademark of Rueda de Casino is in my name and it's here in Cuba.
Y además estamos trabajando en estos momentos para que se convierta el casino como patrimonio de la cultura cubana.
And we are also working really hard to have casino and Rueda de Casino to be acknowledged as part of Cuba's important cultural heritage.
Es como las personas vivimos muchos años.
Evidentemente.
Sí.
Como las personas, como yo vivo muchos años.
So in Cuba, like people like me, we live such a long time.
Yo imagino que se va a declarar el casino patrimonio de la cultura cubana antes de morir.
So I think that they're going to declare a casino cultural heritage before I die.
Es que son procesos.
But they're a long time.
Absolutamente inútil.
And I think that these are kind of useless processes, but here it is.
Pero me alegra que lo reconozcan.
Es que hay que, pero estamos en el proceso, eso sí.
Me alegra que lo reconozcan.
No, no, y sí, hasta la presidenta de patrimonio ha reconocido en la televisión de que entre los próximos espacios que van a tener para patrimonio de la cultura cubana está en casino.
Even the president of the group that acknowledges cultural heritage has acknowledged that casino is going to be one of the next things that's honored.
Hemos tenido ya como 8 o 9 reuniones.
I've been in like 8 or 9 meetings with musicologists and everything talking about this topic.
Por eso digo, yo espero que algún día se declare patrimonio de la cultura cubana. Para mí mucho más fácil va a ser declararlo patrimonio de algo.
I'm really hoping that it will be declared Cuban cultural heritage soon. And then I think it will actually be a lot easier to have it declared as UNESCO World Heritage because it's in so many places in the world. I think that step will be an easier step.
Muchas gracias. Muchísimas gracias.